Good morning and welcome to the Church of the Angels. The church is an independent, non-denominational, interfaith spiritualist assembly. My name is Reverend Jenni Vinecourt. I am your facilitator today, and we'll spend about an hour together today with some prayer, some sharing, and some song. Today is the first of the month, so we will be doing an all-message service today. So thank you for the mediums attending. Feel free to say no if I call on you. For the message portion of our service. A few logistics as we get started. As you know, that you can join us today with just your audio if you choose. You don't have to use your video option because the service is being recorded. And how that works is the only person that shows up on the recording is that person who is speaking. So if you don't want to show up on the recording, your face, then turn off your video when you have a comment or a question or doing message work. But other than that, it's just me that shows up. So don't worry about that. Okay. During the sharing portion of the service, if you want to work or if you have a comment or a question for one of the messages, just wave your hands frantically and or use the chat function to give me a quick hey so I know to call on you. I want to mention that you can also make a donation through the Church of the Angels website. And you'll have an opportunity at that time to make that donation a recurring one if you choose. There is a special donation page on the website, which you can determine where your donation goes, whether it's for the general fund, whether it's for a certain class, one of the meditation circles or the development circle, anything like that. So, and thank you very much to everybody who has donated to help us keep going through this past year. Opening prayer. Mother, Father, Infinite Spirit, thank you for your blessings on all those joining us today to honor your work and experience your grace and wisdom. Thank you for providing the appropriate thoughts, insights, actions, and all resources for us to gain a better and truer understanding of your love by the word spoken and the healing brought forth here today, so that we might lead healthy, happy, and prosperous lives. Thank you for showing us the way to accept responsibility for our lives, and we are grateful to know that you are with us always. So be it. And if you so choose, if you would join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. All right. And now I've asked Anne Marie to read our statement of principles for us. Anne Marie, do you have those ready? Awesome.
I do.
Thank you.
Okay. There is one creative force of which all life is a part. This one creative force is known by many names and manifestations. We recognize and honor the many names and manifestations of the one creative force, the source of all creation, one in God. The energy of life everywhere is continuous. All consciousness is continuous. Communication is continuous. The energy of life, consciousness, and communication never cease, even after the event that is perceived as death. One creates one's own reality. One creates in harmony with the one creative force, the great power of God, of which all life is a part. Reality is as one chooses to perceive and will change as one grows in knowledge of the inner self and one's relationship with the God of his understanding. All things are possible with faith, insight, knowledge, understanding, acceptance, and love. Love is the unifying energy of the universe. It is the energy of the one creative force, the wisdom of God. All life and all mankind are one in the creatorship and healing force of love and with each other. Love is within us and of us. Love is never apart from us. It is we who separate ourselves from the power of love. The force of God works through love and love alone.
Thank you, Anne Marie. Thank you so much. And now we'll have a few moments of quiet meditation, so that we can concentrate on going within to find some peace and calm for ourselves. And okay, apparently my player could use a little calm as well. There we go. So take a deep breath in and let it out. Concentrate on your breath. And let the thoughts flow in and out.
Thank you. Take your time. Come back to the present. And while in this space of peace and calm, please add silently or aloud the names of those you wish to include in this healing energy. Thank you. Please remember that we are always connected to each other and to the divine. Please use this peace and calm to take care of yourselves and all those around you in your communities and throughout the world in whatever way that you can. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Now we'll raise our vibration if everybody's back. Ooh, I'm not sure everybody is back. Well, this might help. And I see that I'm a little quiet for everybody. I'm going to turn up some speakers and see if that's any better. I'm not sure. Let me know if that's any better, guys.
A time you know.
Okay. All right. And today, like I said, it's our spirit message service. But first, I want to ask, is there anybody who would like to share briefly how spirit has touched their life this week? You need to wave your hands frantically as my glasses are a little dirty today. Oh, Judy Naren, you're up.
I don't know that I've ever shared in this opportunity. Not that, of course, it hasn't been there, but this one was really stood out to me because in this time of Mercury retrograde, it was in my world in full stream. And I didn't even know what was going on, but I went, what the heck? And then I discovered that. But anyway, so something that really affected us, you know, money coming in because the people who were processing my credit cards weren't sending, giving me my money. And this went on for weeks and I get passed around. I had to even ask a doctor, he went into his QuickBooks and he had them call me. It was just wild. And so I had another call to make, still wasn't resolved. So I went and I just prayed over it. And I just said, I started seeing everything with love, everything with love, everything with love, everything with love. And then I saw the outcome that I wanted, just easy and effortless, just float. And son of a gun, for the first time, second pastor, I got right to the right person, somebody that actually knew their stuff. He stayed with it every step of the way and kept working to problem solve it. And it was just a beautiful, effortless experience. So I'm so grateful.
Awesome. Thank you for sharing, Judy. Thank you so much. Anybody else? Let me make a quick look on the other screen. Oh, Batya, go ahead, please. Oh, no, you were just thumbs upping. Okay, never mind. All right. Let's see. La, 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 la. Okay, I don't see anybody else. So if I miss somebody, please hit me up in chat. But I'll give you one quick one from me. As you, some of you know, I've been having some great difficulty pulling things together lately. And I want to say that this past weekend and all during this week, you know, I've been involved in a class and in intensive meditation and finding self. And it's come at a most opportune time. Spirit brought it to me just when I needed it, just when the other things that I needed to do, whether that be doctors, whether that be diet, whether that be, you know, all of that, all came together and at a most opportune time. And I give thanks for that. So, all right. Thank you for allowing me to share. Now, some quick announcements. Let me do announcements first. Sorry. Okay. Next week, our speaker is Carol Miller. Is that correct, Carol? Yes. All right. And next week is Valentine's Day. So I look forward to that. This week we have virtual meditation with Reverend Renee on Wednesday at 7 p.m. This Thursday is virtual thought exchange with Patrice at 7 p.m. Saturday is Give Yourself a Visionary Valentine event. And that is Saturday, February 13th at 7 p.m. That is run by Reverend Vicki and Reverend Carol. There are a couple of different options there. You can pay through PayPal for that event. It's $21 for the group message work that's going to be going on that evening. If you choose to have a private reading, it's $36. And then one of the mediums will contact you to set up that private reading with them. And I do believe that all donations or most donations are going to benefit the church. In March, look forward to another advanced mediumship course with Reverend Ann Bartlett. We are also having a food drive on a weekend parking lot drop-off. that's coming up in March. And also, we will be running Reverend Barbara Douglas will be running a four-part series, and it starts in March on abundance. So I look very forward to that as well. Just a really quick shout out. If anybody, I'm looking at possibly running the ceremonies for ministers course again online through the church. So if there is anybody who is interested in that, please throw me an email and let me know that you're interested in that. And because I have not set that up or set up a date yet. Okay, any announcements from the floor? Okay, I'm not seeing any. If I missed you, please throw me a chat. All right, and now we'll move into some message work. As spiritualists, we do believe that the energy of all beings is forever linked and that all of us have direct access to the love and guidance of loved ones, guides, teachers, saints, and healers on the other side. We do have mediums here who have joined us today who can be of service and connect with spirit, to bring forth a few messages for us. And as I said in the beginning, feel free to say no, not today, if you're not feeling it. But I'd like to start with Carol Miller. Would you serve spirit for us today?
Sure, thank you. I'd be happy to.
Thank you.
Brooke Mowry, would you like a message? Are we getting a yes? Where'd you go, Brooke? Where'd you go?
I couldn't get anything.
Oh, there you are, honey. Hi. You know, as I stepped in with your energy, you just have such a nice, positive, light energy. You're just kind of projecting it right out. And I do feel like a grandmother type spirit stepping in, maybe grandparents, maybe not just grandmother, grandparents, but predominantly grandmother. And she's, let's see what she's saying. Of course, she's sending love and how much she just adored you, little, and she still does. And she's saying that you're doing okay during these troubled times. Just keep doing what you're doing. Just like one foot after the other, one after the other, and you're gonna be okay. Now I got a sense of a younger, and I don't know if it's like a niece or nephew or somebody that you're helping some. And she said that's a really young the child. It's also helpful to you. It perks your spirit up too. And it's just really a good thing for you. And I also got a sense of a small dog just kind of popping in and out too. I don't know if it was grandma's dog or your dog, but the little doggy wants to say hi to. And the message is just keep moving forward. You're doing great. And grandma sends that with love and light. And I leave that with you with love and light.
Oh, thank you, Carol. That all makes sense.
Oh, cool. Thank you. Thank you. And you know, Judy Nairn, would you like a message? I don't think
I would.
Judy, you know, as you were, even before you started talking earlier, I sensed your dad coming in. And then as you talked about what occurred this week, I have to say dad helped. Dad helped with that, but that really wasn't the message from Dad. The message from Dad is that you're going to start do something new. Not that you haven't over the past done lots of new things, because you have, but there's something new coming on the horizon for you. That's kind of different for you, that you're really gonna like. It's something a little slower, quiet, a little less stressful. And that's sending that to you with the support and blessing. And I'll leave that with you with love.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Reverend Jenni, should I do one more?
If you've got one more, sure, go right ahead.
Okay. Let's see who else I wrote it. You know, Lydia, I was looking at you earlier. There you are. Would you?
Yes, I'd like one.
Actually, who I saw coming in for you was also your dad. And your grandma and grandma, I saw two people coming in for you. Let's start with grandma. Grandma, I sense just like traditional grandma love and food and warmth. And she's still sending that to you every single day. Grandma's still with you. And she says, if you get stressed or upset, just almost sit back in that loving energy and you'll find it comforting. And from dad sends a hi and a wave and hello and just wants you to know that he's with you. I'm hearing every step of the way. I just saw like a sailboat. I don't know what that relates to. If dad did any sailing or if it's symbolic of something, I don't want to say someplace new because you move around so much. We don't want you moving away from us, but you can take a sail, a trip somewhere, and dad's always with dad is saying those trips are good for you, and he's always with you on those. And I'm gonna leave that with you with love and light.
Thank you.
And thank you, Reverend Jenni, for allowing me to serve.
Thank you, Carol. Sure. Reverend Carol Wood, would you like to serve spirit today?
Yes, thank you. Good morning. Anthony, would you like a message?
I'm getting a nod, yes, Carol.
Yeah, okay. Hi, Anthony.
Yes.
I have got one of your guides behind you. Looks like a big Roman soldier. He's got armor and a staff and everything, and he's saying, he's cutting leaves and trees and branches out the way. So he's clearing the path. He said he's clearing the path for you to start taking some steps forward. That your journey's beginning, it's opening up, and they're making a way, a direction for you to go in. Okay. He wants you to know he's behind you and that just keep pushing through. That you're coming to a big breakthrough soon and everything will just really flow into place in the next few months. And I leave that with you, the Spirit's blessing.
Thank you so much. It's amazing. Thank you.
good. And I have one more, Jackie Cheney, would you like a message?
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Is your father in spirit, Jackie?
Yes.
Yes, okay. He's coming to me, and he's standing behind you, and he's showing me that he's under, got both of your arms, and he's holding you up, okay? He's like, I'm hoping you stand strong right now. So I don't know what may be going on, but he's showing that just keep your stance, stand strong. All of this will pass. But you need to just stay strong and grounded. So do as much grounding energy as you can right now. But he has your back, okay? He's grabbing you under the shoulders and saying, I got you, okay? And I leave that with you with Spirit's blessing.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for allowing me to serve.
Thank you, Reverend Carol. Brooke Maury, are you so inspired today? You're still muted. I can't tell whether that's a yes or a no.
Oh, sorry. I always forget that I have to unmute. Yeah. Actually, Jenni, would you like a message?
Well, yes, I would love one. Thank you, Brooke.
I think I end up having messages for you because yours is the face that's prominent on my phone. And I try and look through to see if there's somebody else I might have a message for. But nonetheless, that's okay. So while we were doing the meditation, spirit came to me and I kept seeing with you, they kept showing me you being held right now, kind of like cradled like a baby. And the spirit that came to me showing that moment specifically, it was multiple. It was almost like there was multiple of them holding you at once. It felt motherly. That one felt very motherly, but also like a grandfather. Those two specifically, a mother and your grandfather. The message along with that also is that, and it was also for me, eagerness can stall our growth when it comes to our healing. And I know I end up having that issues sometimes with message work and, you know, with anybody else with their own, whether it's physical or emotional or mental healing, that we get in our own way with eagerness. And they reminded me of the Bruce Lee quote, "Be like water." And so that was the overall message that I had today. But that was it. Yeah, I only had that one today though.
All right. Thank you so much, Brooke. Thank you.
It does make sense.
Thank you so much. And thank you for serving. Thank you much.
Thank you for allowing me to serve.
Reverend Linda, Linda Kupiak, are you so inspired today with some messages?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Alicia, would you like a message today?
Yes, thank you.
As I understand, you feel that you are surrounded in a big fog. And spirit wants you to know that you're allowed to walk through that fog and not to allow the fog, like fog your perception. There is so much present for you right now, and you are surrounded by a brightness that, as I understand, that you're looking for, that you don't realize that you have. But Alicia, it is, you are light, it is shining. And as you allow that, as you allow that to shine forth more, that fog is going to lift for you. Believe in yourself. You are an authentic person, a spirit person. And don't doubt that, Alicia. Believe that and really, really take it to heart, because that's where it's all in, the heart. They would like to see you stand up more, stand up for yourself. Standing up for yourself not only gives you courage, but it gives you a lightness, like a lift. So you're not as heavy. You don't feel that you're sinking in. You don't like that feeling. You like to be flying. You're happier when you're lifted up, when you're flying. And you have a strong female energy with you. Alicia, this energy is supporting you. There's also a quite strong masculine energy present. And he can be, on the earth plane, he was quirky at times, but then he had more of a gentleness about him. He is holding your heart with that gentleness. And he wants you to know that even though you felt he wasn't always near you here in the earth plane, he is so near you right now, Alicia. And he's touching you. And when you feel a little tug, or if you feel like you're leaning back a little bit, know that you're resting in those wonderful, and he wants you to know, strong, in those strong arms. because he's here for you. And he would like to help put a lens, a clearer lens in front of you. So you see the beauty that you are. Don't lose the beauty that you know you are. You are a real person, Alicia, and a beautiful presence in this earth plane. And there is just so much love to you. I'll leave that with you.
Thank you.
Let's see. Anne Marie, would you like a message?
Yes, thank you.
Just have to get you on my screen. Sorry about that. Spirit wants to think of the word. It's something like congratulate you. You have been stepping into who you are, the person you are meant to be, the real you, that authentic you. The steps that you have taken has helped you reach a point of knowing, well, who you are, believing in yourself, that self-love. And as you continue to walk, on your, as any path, paths have twists and turns. And of course, we're all apprehensive as we go through twists and turns, but don't be afraid though. Because you have your presence will lead you. And you also have this beautiful female energy with you. I don't know, a mom, could be a grandma, someone that you knew and who knew you, somebody that you enjoyed her company with. You enjoyed it in the kitchen, you enjoyed it outside playing. And this lady just gives you so much, this lady gives you kudos for who you are. You are like elevated from where she was, from how she looked out at things. You have that special knowledge with inside you, and she just claps for you. And as you move forward, your path is open for you. But just, they caution you, when you come to a twist and turn, don't panic. Don't say, what am I going to do? Just that one step at a time, and you enjoy your path. And I'll leave that with you.
Thank you.
Thank you for allowing me to serve.
Thank you, Linda. Thank you so much. Angeline, are you so inspired for one or two today? Well, come back to me if you are, if you change your mind. How about Anne Marie? Would you like to serve spirit today?
Sure, I'd be happy to.
Thank you.
Let's see. Tanda, would you like a message?
Yes, I would. Thank you.
Okay. As I touch in with you, I'm getting the name George. I'm not sure if this is someone you're familiar with. Does that resonate with you at all?
No.
Okay. Maybe just someone, an acquaintance that just wants to pop in to see how you're doing. And he's showing me a window ledge with a key. See what this he's saying about this. And the key is, and he said there's a box. This may be figurative, but as the box opens, I just see all these hearts coming out and just so much love and spirits. This is a gift to you, but also you have many gifts that you can share with others. And they're happy with what you've done so far. And I encourage you to keep sharing that you have so much. And they're plant seeds. You're going to be learning and things that you're going to be sharing. Saying springtime. Maybe this is something that's going to be growing and coming to fruition in the spring, but just to keep, they're saying, keep up the good work, and they're just so happy that you're doing all this good work. I leave that with Spirit's blessing.
Thank you.
I do have one more. Let me see. Luann Baker, may I come to you? Okay.
You nodded yes.
Okay, I'm getting a sister energy. Do you have a sister that's in spirit?
No.
Okay.
I'm in spirit anyway.
Someone who's like a sister, my friend, and she's just saying how happy she is right now. To know once. She's right next to you, that she's there. She's showing that you're sort of like riding on a wave. You're on top of the wave where it's going up and down and up and down, but you're not falling in. You're still on top of that wave. And she's saying, you just got to ride the wave. You're just like a wave comes in to shore. It's going to bring you into shore. You're not going to fall. You're not, not to be frightened of anything where it is difficult up and down, but just to know that you're supported. And she's showing me like you on the surfboard that, but you're not going to fall in. She said that you're just so supported with a lot of love. Maybe just a guide that's coming through for you, but they just want you to, it is okay that they are there with you all along. And I leave that with Spirit's blessing. Okay, and thank you for allowing me to serve.
Thank you, Anne-Marie. Thank you so much. Reverend Barbara Douglas, do you have one or two today?
Yes. Okay. The first four I had, somebody is already done.
Yep, that happens.
Quite interesting. So know that your spirit guides, your angelic presences, your ancestors are quite strong today. Linda Kubiak, would you like a message? Yes?
Yes, I heard a yes.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry. Yes, please.
Okay. Jophiel is with you today, and this is so interesting. He, she, angel and archangels are kind of sexless, but they're saying if you have glitter or if you have fairy dust, they would like you to sort of scatter it around on your carpet a bit so that you see it as you move through the house or anywhere you are, to remind you of the great joy that you are, the great joy that you share. And as you continue to open up to this joy, which I'm sure you know and you have, but it's like, please focus on it more now. And somehow that is going to expand you in a way so that something new and something you're going to want, I don't know that you want it now, but that you're going to want when it gets there, will be able to come into your life and expand your life. Yes. And I leave that with you as Spirit's blessing.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. And Sumika, are you open to receiving a message? Sumika?
Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. This is someone on your mother's side. It's a man. It's way far back. I don't think it was a grandfather, great grandfather, but I think it would have been like a great uncle. Mm. But it's like all the way back to, he looks like he's dressed like Abraham Lincoln, that kind of long waistcoat. And he's very tall and thin, and clearly you never knew him on a physical level. But he's telling you two things. One, it's important to breathe in through your nose and breathe out through your mouth. Breathe in through your nose, breathe out through your mouth. And I'm telling you that activates the parasympathetic nervous system and calms you down. But his message is just to do it, to do it. And he sees that kind of breathing as helping you, calming you, and in your case, also allowing something else to come through. The calm is like expanding you. So there's room for something else. Yes. I leave that with you as Spirit's blessing.
Thank you.
I think that's it, Reverend Jenni.
All right. Thank you so much for serving.
Thank you for letting me serve.
Certainly. Angeline, I understand that you have one for us.
Yes, I do. I have trouble unmuting. Sharon Paskey, would you like a message?
Yes.
Yeah. I see some, I keep hearing the word baby. I'm seeing someone who left your life too early. I don't know if it was a it's a young person, and it's like, baby, everything's going to be all right. And they're showing me that you're ruminating. You're like thinking over and over a decision, just going back and forth. And should I, could I, would have. Does that make sense? Okay. Well, they want you to know that it's going to be okay. No matter, you did nothing wrong. It wasn't your role. You didn't have a decision to make. It's just something that happened, and it's going to be okay. And the baby is like, treat yourself gently. Treat yourself very gently and move forward. Don't ruminate. Just make the decision with all that you have in your heart and move forward with that decision. They love you so much. This person who, they were gone too early from your life, and they love you so much. And they just want you to move forward and be your best self. And I leave that with you with love and light.
Thank you. Thank you for serving, Angeline. Thank you so much. Reverend Cindy Hudson, would you finish us up, please?
I sure will. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. And actually, this is a different way of doing a message for me today, all these names, and I'm not even going to list them off, all the people that started lighting up on my screen, need to hear this message, and then it came through even larger. So I really want everybody to maybe give a moment's thought to this message, because Archangel Raphael, the Archangel of Healing, is coming through really strongly. Like it's choking me up so strongly, because there are some people that are so in need that are on this Zoom session right now. And if this doesn't apply to you, it applies to some people that you know. And he wants you to call on, he, she, wants you to call on the healing energy that this being, this guide has. And this guide wants you to know, this archangel wants you to know that there isn't even a doubt of a question of worthiness, of deservedness. It is there for each and every one of you on this Zoom, in your communities, in the world around. It's not even a question. It's like, is it going to be cloudy in Cleveland, Ohio in February? Yeah. Are you worthy? Absolutely not even a question. No doubt. No doubt. And with this healing comes the challenge, this energy, I want to say he because it's just easier, is saying that the challenge is in stopping those old tapes. Many of us on this session, many of those in our lives have been raised in a situation where we were taught that we were less than and that we were not deserving of. And that's old news, people. We need to stop that old news. And we need to try to pretend, even if it's a stretch, then you can, it's okay to try to pretend, maybe I am worthy. Maybe I am deserving of this healing. And with that healing, it's physical, it's mental, it's emotional on all levels. And it is there for each and every one of us beyond a shadow of a doubt. Receive it. Ask and you shall receive. No doubt. And I leave that with Raphael's blessings. Thank you, people. Thank you, Reverend Jenni.
Thank you, Cindy. Thank you so much for that. And thank you to all the mediums that work today. And Spirit, along with Cindy's message, the book that they have me reading from today is You Are Enough by Panache Desai. I'm not sure how to pronounce him, but that's okay. And this is what it says. Revealing your essential self is a process of coming into harmony and alignment with your soul, which requires that you accept and embrace all that you are. Every quality, every nuance, every experience, every perceived mistake, everything you see as bad, ugly, divisive, or destructive. I understand that this may seem sometimes beyond what you think you're capable of. It might feel like pressing upon a throbbing subdermal infection, hot and painful to the slightest touch. Or maybe you're so disassociated from your internal conflicts that you don't even know where to start. I've heard every excuse for why this journey may seem too overwhelming to even begin. You don't know what I've done. You can't imagine whom I've hurt. You don't know the sins I've committed. You'd walk away from me if you realize the magnitude of my mistakes. As much as these statements may seem convincing or even true to you, and here's the important part, they can never invalidate the ultimate truth. You are loved by God exactly as you are right now in this moment. And with that, I want to thank you for your kind attention. Thank you to all participants and the mediums, and especially to Spirit and to the God of your understanding for being with us today and always. For those who might be new with us today, you can learn more about the Church of the Angels at our website, which is www.thechurchoftheangels.net, or you can email us at thechurchoftheangels@gmail.com. And now we'll have one more song before our closing prayer.
Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day, this healing, this healing, this healing day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. Thank you for my health, Spirit. Thank you for my health. Thank you for my health, Spirit. Thank you for my health. My radiant. Radiant, my radiant health, my radiant health. Thank you for my life, Spirit. Thank you for my life. Thank you for my life, Spirit. Thank you for my life. My glorious, my glorious, my glorious life. My glorious, my glorious, my glorious life. Thank you for my wealth, Spirit. Thank you for my wealth. Thank you for my wealth, Spirit. Thank you for my wealth. My opulent, my opulent, my opulent wealth. My opulent, my opulent, my opulent wealth. Thank you for the day, Spirit. Thank you for the day. Thank you for the day, Spirit. Thank you for the day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. Thank you for the day, Spirit.
In closing, let us pray. Infinite Spirit, Mother, Father, God, as we move forward, we thank you in advance for the guidance and resources you always provide for us to live the fullest expression of your love. We pray for those affected by the circumstances throughout our world and our communities at this time. May we always be reminded of the opportunities to reconnect in love to all those around the world, to Mother Earth and the universe. Amen.